Dr. Wan Zanaria. We are from group 6 and we are going to present about the topic variable weight application in case study. Okay, this is the list name of group 6 and it is the introduction of VRA. VRA basically has two basic technology, which is map-based method and the second is sensor-based method. For the map-based method, it is about to apply to soil type, soil color and texture. Also about the topography, the crop yield, field data and remotely sensor image and numerous location source based on a location specific. For the second basic technology is sensor-based. It is capable to vary the application rate of inputs with no mapping or data collection. And this VRA can be used to seeding management, the control width and technical control. Okay, the VRA, basically the definition of VRA is about to apply crop inputs in a non-uniform manner based on vary needs throughout a field with advantages. The advantages are including higher average yields, lower farm input cost and environmental benefit from applying a fewer inputs to the crop.
Okay, next is we are going to look on the scenes on the in California according to Ben William Farms, and he has 800 of acres of farms, which 600 of acres he used to plant their crops using the conventional methods, whereas 200 acres using variable rate technology. From the 600 acres, he observed that the yield achieved the uniforms and also the growth also uniform. And whereas in the 200 acres, which is using VRT, he observed that the variability result from the growth, soil fertility and yield. And the main crop of his farm is cotton, alfalfa and black eyed peas, and which is alfalfa is one of the variability problem, but he hopes to achieve more form of crop from the cotton and corn. Okay, there are advantage of variable rate technology in economics and environmental. In economics, we can increase input efficiency, which is we apply the things that only we need for the farms, and we can reduce the overall amount of input use, and also improve in field equipment, and also to improve crop yield through the optimal inputs. And in environmental, we can minimize over applications, thereby reducing the risk of pesticide and fertilizer, and also to reduce application in environmentally sensitive area. Two variable rate application used by Tennyson AG service, which is apply 600 soil amendments and one liquid in one pass across the field can increase the nitrogen in the soil.
In Muhammad and today, I will present about the benefit of using variable rate application. So the first benefit is it can overcome the fertilizer application and maximize the fertilizer benefit by only applying it at the best part. As you can see, the farmer only give fertilizer to the crop when it is needed and not on all surface, because fertilizer cost can be lower or stay the same by doing this. Then the crop yielding will be higher and uniform all through it. Next, the soil sampling by Tennyson AG service. The application of VRT on top plantation may require expensive for startup costs. The quarter startup cost mostly due to soil sampling. Soil sampling, the costs are very high because they need to make a new place for planting agri area. The local consulting economist has reached 3100 million electrical conductivity of soil to determine homogeneous region for plantation. Next.
This is an example of the agronomist throughout the various to field by self-definition in the GPS is every few seconds to identify the homogeneous of the region of the soil. So then he reflected data into the map. So it can indicate the shape and boundary of the soil type at the specific area. So this is another application of variable rate technology, which help to deliver fertilizer, which is remarkable precision and allowed to apply different rate of the fertilizer as need well across the field, because different area we may be need a different amount of fertilizer depend on the soil nutrient. So the technology needed to for the variable rate fertilizer is include computer, software, and then fertilizer equipment for the different rate.
Transition to the Malaysian farming system. Okay. Okay. The first is variable rate technology to fertilizer application, and which is it can to reduce seedling injury with the good weed control and also reducing injury in non-uniform soils. Okay, maximization of fertilizer use. In Malaysia, use the farming system which can improve by minimize the rate of increase in fertilizer use by emerging technologies such as BRA. And plant breeders should explore the possibility of producing a crop which are higher yielding but less demanding as the required nutrient requirement. Next. Okay, the third is training workers. As we know, BRA use the high technology, which is must to handle with well. Thus by training the young people to farm industry in Malaysia, together with the collaboration of the precision agriculture technologies, may reduce the negative impact of the agriculture activities to environment, people, animals, and also plants. Okay, next.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Zati Sofia. Okay, I will further continue about the improvement in Malaysia, which is variable rate application to rice precision farming. BRT is developed for fertilizer application in rice precision farming. It is developed system that consists of field data collection, processing and analyzing unit, treatment map, and also variable rate applicator. This is one of the software that can be used in rice precision farming, which is fertilizer calculation software. It is based on the GAI Green Area Index to calculate the fertilizer NPK that applied for the rice farming, and the total amount of fertilizer for specific management zone is determined by using this software. How VRA works on fertilizer application in rice precision farming? First, the tractor driver implement is used for variable rate fertilizer application. As we can see, this tractor is implemented with the VRA system so that all the farmers can interpret the data into the tractor. So next, field computer merit from treatment map to apply the fertilizer quantity and field location. Then it sends the signal to the VRA controller. After we collect the data from the tractor, the data will be sent to the VRT controller. The field location is guided through tractor mounted with GPS, and then when spreader reach position signal, the VRA controller trigger metering device. This VRT controller will interpret the data into this map. So, the data will interpret to control spreader orifice at specific size equivalent to required mount. So that the map will show how many fertilizer rate to apply on that area, like this. Okay, this is the conclusion. Overall, variable rate application is very useful skills in for Malaysia. The farmers not only know the basic step of farming, but also every details such as soil fertility, seeds, chemicals to use, fertilizer, and etc. Nation should take these available opportunities because we planted crops such as oil palm and paddy rice. And other than that, it can also attract more young people to participate in this industry sector. That's all from us. Thank you.